What's up, sports fans? We're back at it.
What's up, Metal?
She's shiny.
Bum, 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 bum. That's looking good. bum, 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 bum. Ooh, too white.
No,
shit. I don't know. I use just linseed oil. I use linseed oil, and I got these makeup sponges that I got on Amazon. It's like little wedges, little sponge wedges, and I just put some oil on there. My biggest reason is because the colors sink in. They become really flat. And I can't quite judge the values because all the light, like the values here will get a lot lighter. Now I just use a little bit of oil. Light as coat as I can put on there. As light as, oh fuck. That's too dark.
How's the big one going, Grumpy? Yeah, I try to keep like the amount of like I just use linseed oil to fatten up my paint to make it more viscous. And so I just use the same thing to I just put it into this, but I just use the same thing to the medium. I think that if you just intuitively, I think that using a whole bunch of different stuff is just whatever I was using for medium, I would probably use, you know what I mean? I wouldn't use like 50 different things. I think that's just asking for, that's just adding layers of complexity. I think it can be better spent. You have to pick your battles. Oh, fuck. How much time do you have left on Andre? A week? 2 weeks? A couple days? I've been watching the video updates. It's just, it's hard to tell sometimes how close you are. Because I'm like, oh, that looks good. And then you'll keep doing stuff. And I'm like, oh, yeah, he was right. That looks better. What's up, Veronica? How you doing, dude? Is my painting almost done? No, my painting, this painting is done. No. I gotta do the whole bottom. I gotta do the whole field. I gotta do the whole bottom. So the top is close. The top is, yeah. I'm kind of like mediocre on the top, to be perfectly honest. I just don't feel like some of those, I don't know. I don't know how I feel about this painting, to be perfectly honest. Like, I'll just keep going on it, but, I don't think it's going to be, I don't think, I don't know. I don't, what do I think? I don't think this will be my favorite necessarily. That's okay though. Can't, it doesn't matter what I think. It doesn't matter what I think. I think sometimes your opinion is the most important. Like, I think you try to do your best, and in that sense, your opinion is important. But I think that afterwards, you, like, why does somebody pick a painting? It's not because it's technically the best. It's just because, like, they just liked it. When I was whinging about the background there, I was thinking, like if the background's not where I want it, just like toss the whole thing. You know what I mean? Instead of putting it out there and just be like, oh, well, not everyone could be like, you know, still a little piece, got to keep the quality up or whatever. But, I don't know where I stand. I like the composition. I think I just don't like some of the brushwork in the background. I think I got to start using primer on my stuff. They come primed already, but I'm going to start using like a different, I bought some stuff. It's in the mail, hopefully. Thank you. I think I'll pull it together. I don't think it's going to be a thrower away.
It'll be okay.
Let's do this back and forth. A little bit of a sound dance. I know. I guess the dilemma that I was trying to describe before was that I think that you should try to put out your best pieces, and that you should definitely cull your weakest ones, like whatever. Like, especially for me right now, like not everything I'm producing is like going to be necessarily a winner. So I don't think I should be afraid to throw out like the bottom 10% of the paintings that I make, like literally. But with that being said, the bottom like 20% of the paintings that I make, like there's a level somewhere where it's like they might not be perfect, but they're pretty good. Like, do I feel like I don't want to put out subpar work, you know what I mean, and have that in my house. But at the same time, if somebody likes it, you got to make the decision like where you're comfortable with letting them go. I'm looking at this like that I'm looking at this like I'm in the student phase of like my art career, and that if people want to buy shit right now, that's cool. That's how I look at it. Yeah, I like the dress right now. I think I could have used a little bit more colors in it. I could have used more, but it's got some good variety in it. There's some good things about this painting. There's a couple little things right now where I'm just like, I wish we'll just keep working stuff, you know. Let's do this. Look, there's kind of some greens and some reds and some blues, but just mostly like grayscale. They're really subtle. They're not bold. They're very subtle. It looks way better. I don't know. It's starting to look really good, actually. I changed my mind. No, it's looking way better than it did, I guess, is the good way to put it. Sometimes you got to take that step back. Hey, what's up, TMTX woman? Okay, I'll turn it off. Yeah, that's what someone had suggested to me about that I should change it. And I thought, oh, that's a good idea. That makes a good point. Yeah, my YouTube friend Kelsey told me that. And I was like, she said it. I was like, oh, yeah, that's a good point, dude. At first, I was just trying to make it easy, but now that I'm in such a routine with it, I can make things a little bit more complicated. Let the public be your judge. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense to me. Okay, now we gotta come down here with this foot. The only problem with painting feet is that when you have feet in your painting, then everybody makes fun of you and think you have a thing for feet. Maybe that's just my friend's maybe this is my friend's roasting me. But that's been my experience. It's like, oh, why did you paint those? No, actually, that's like people think that if you paint something, it means that you love that thing. They're like, oh, why'd you paint that girl? Oh, do you love her? I just say yes. Uh-huh. That's what I say.
Need more white.
Okay, what do we want to do? Maybe we'll do something just different. Mixes. Seven baby machines. Something about this foot is weird. This is the poop. Let's do more red. I guess I could have zoomed in. We're a little late now. Boom, bum, 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 bum. Where are we at for time? 44 minutes. We're doing okay. Okay, I think it's coming along. Let's get a little bit more shaping on this. What's up, Rhiannon? Just painted. Oh, what the hell? My camera turned off. Hold on. I'll get it back. Why did that happen? Why did that happen? That happened twice now. Baloney, guys. Oh, you jinxed me, dude. A little bit more over here. Crown the rise. Dark magic. Witchcraft. If there's one thing that'll put you to sleep, it's the Shark Show.
Bum 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 bum.
I gotta sit back a little bit. Everyone likes this one more than me. Thanks. That's what I should say. I had to learn how to take compliments. So now I just say, thank you. Anytime someone says something, even if I think that they're saying it to be mean or rude, I just say, thank you. Just saying thank you, that's always the best. Just thank you. Thanks. I try not to put caveats on it. But every time I'm like, short circuiting. Can you give me a compliment, bro? Because Terrence wants to wear this dress, he says. What you doing, Meatball? Hello, team. I think we'll probably just take the a little bit further. Tomorrow we'll come in and we'll do a whole coat on the bottom. It might take 2 days to do the bottom. I'm not quite sure. Maybe if I actually have a good day tomorrow. I gotta figure it out. See you, Grumpy. Thanks for popping in, man. Here's... Oh, shoot. Fuck. Undo, undo. Delete, delete. Multitudes are marching. Everybody's leaving. I'm probably only going to pay for the, I'm probably only going to pay for just over an hour today anyways, but not everybody's leaving me. You jerks. No, I'm just kidding. Thanks for being here, guys. Appreciate you. They'll be when the man comes around. It's unjust. Let him be unjust still. Whoever is righteous, let him be righteous still. Let him be filthy still. To the words long written down. When the man comes around. Dun, 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 dun. Johnny Cash. He's a poet. He's an old poet. You probably don't know him. Johnny Cash didn't sing Big R, and that's Marty Robbins. Maybe he did sing Big R. Look at this. I found it. He did sing Big R, but that's Marty Robbins still. What about the man who shot the Liberty Valance? I like that song. Bum, 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 bum. When Liberty Valance rolled to town, the women folk would hide. They'd hide. When Liberty Valance walked around. Cause the point of the gun was the only law. Yeah, Johnny Cash did lots of people's songs. And out of the east a stranger came, a law book in his hand, a man. The kind of a man the West would need to tame the troubled land. See, dude. Many a man would fit as well. Many a man would fall. He was the greatest of them all. All that night. The man who shot.
He was mighty good.
Do our fingers? No, our fingers are good. Okay, I think we're just about done for the day. Tomorrow we'll come in and we'll do the this bottom part. We'll see where we get to, I think. Okay, I think I'm done, guys, for the day. I said a good spot. I can fix some of this stuff. No, it's pretty good, actually. We'll come in and we'll do the stuff tomorrow, the bottom, the grass. But that's it. Peace.